Good afternoon, Barry Drennan from H2H. People have been asking a lot about instructional videos and this type of thing, so we just want to give you a little sample out there, see how you feel about it, and get your feeling back on it. I have my friend Eric with me today. Eric is very good for this particular case, because Eric has not trained at all in Fairbairn method. Have you trained something before?
No, not at all.
Okay, so we don't have any background with regard to Fairbairn method at all, so we're going to be teaching a little bit. We're going to bring a little bit from language and motion, and just the introduction to that as well, and get that information out to you. It's very simple, and we're going to see somebody go from scratch to something in just a few minutes. That's the whole concept here. We don't want to spend an hour here. We want to spend just a few minutes doing some basic transfer, some basic thought lines, and that's it. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to start off with a basic kick. So now the basic kick that we're going to be using, like in motion, is a small kick. It's very short. It comes along the bottom. And what we're going to do is, let me get you to stand over here. That way the camera catches the movement better. And so the movement comes off. I'm going to give it, go over my right foot. So the movement comes off the right foot. It travels like this. It travels as if you're kicking a soccer ball. As if you're going to kick a soccer ball to your passive soccer ball, better said, to your partner. We do not arc the kick. Why? Because if we arc the kick, we have to time the arc with your leg coming. So we don't know if you're forward on a stride, rearward on a stride, or partway through a stride. We can't afford to have that kind of error problematic our situation, cause a problem to how that technique works. So when that tech kick goes, it comes in straight across the ground. They shoot it straight out. So if you're walking towards me, walk towards me now, I can come in and just kick directly into that leg. We want to catch you on the shin. And the reason for that is because there's secondary movement, so we can move off that, recapture, and straight down. And this is what we do, we run in straight down the body. So it's a very simple kick. We'll reverse again, you're right left-handed, right? Yeah, so we'll reverse again so we can catch the throne correctly, and they'll demonstrate, they'll be able to see that movement and demonstrate. So we come in straight through, and it's like this. Now, understand, there's three ways you can do this kick. You can walk towards me, and I can kick you on the movement. I can walk towards you, and go to the kick. Or, you can come towards me, and I can meet you halfway, and do that kick. So the kick works the same way, regardless of whether I'm in stationary position, whether I'm in a moving position, or have somebody move on me. Follow?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll switch around. And now that's the same kick. Now what I'm going to do is just stand here, hit my leg for you. And I just want to see that kick coming nice and straight. Back right there, yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Simple as that. That's it. Now, parallel to the floor, like you're kicking a soccer ball. Yeah, see now you're arcing. So you want to be parallel to the floor.
Oh, okay.
So you're yeah.
The feet's flat.
That's right. That's right. And you kick with the inside arch here, because that inside arch helps us capture around the bone that is the tibia. All right, so try it again. Now, I have protection on you, so you can put this kick in really well. Okay, go. That's it, that's the idea. As simple as that. Okay, do it again. Okay, a little harder. All right, so this is it. Boom, okay, so that's that kick that comes in. Now the same thing, when I start moving towards you, I'll wait, you wait till I get to you. So I'm going to advance now, you have a problem in the parking lot, I'll advance forward, and then the kick. You start to kick with that movement, boom, just like that. It starts exactly like that. So it works in that simple fashion. I go towards you, I become stationary, you decide you're going to make it a preemptive movement, and bang, that kick goes in. Boom, that's it. Now you can kick that hard enough, you knock my leg back. Yeah. Okay, that type of movement, okay? So now I might add a little bit to that to show the movement, but that's the concept, and we're not going to kill each other here, so we're training. So same thing, now if I come towards you, and you want to meet me halfway, you're not going to wait in this situation. I've told you I'm going to kill you, I'm going to do this, I'm going to beat you up, I'm going to harm you, you're thinking about your wife, your kids, you're not going to wait for this to happen, you're going to catch me halfway. Now you don't care where my drive is. All you care is that when you're close enough, you know your foot can reach. Okay? So that's what's going to gear. We're not going to be targeting. We're not going to be going down looking for that leg and finding that leg to kick. As soon as we get close to that person, boom, that kick will come forward and violently strike into my leg. Alright? So you're going to meet me halfway. Alright? We're coming along now again. Boom! And that's it. You see? And that's the stage. When we strike into this leg, of course we're going to be causing pain and we're going to get a reflex off of that. So this is the first movement. Very easy to adapt to. Very easy to concentrate on in terms of your awareness of other things going on around you. You don't have to really think about it. It's not like a roundhouse kick where you have to worry about all your balances and everything. It's just straightforward driving that boot in, and it comes under the radar, which is great for breaking his concentration, element of surprise, and taking them off guard. Now, what we're going to do next, step forward a little bit, with two techniques, okay? And they work off each other very easily. What I want to show you is how one can walk into the other and we create a dominant position. Okay, so we're going to change again so that we have that movement on film. And you're going to see, as he moves in towards me, I take this leg, I strike it in. He will reflex off that leg. In which case, I'll touch base and it'll drive him up to the testicles. All right? Very, very simple again. Very straightforward. All right? So same movement. Now, I'm protected big time. I got on guards. He's ready to go. Do not kill me, but you can put in a little bit of movement. All right? So same thing. He has to use the first movement, which is the kick, and instep kick, and then he's going to follow directly by touching down and then coming up through the center of the fork and going to the testicles. Ready? Okay, go. That's it. As simple as that. Now, I would advise you that when you do this, get your hands up. Get your hands up in the face. Get your hands up in the body posture. No matter what it is, even if it's catching people's hands, or just blocking people's hands, or just smearing their movement, is great. Because this is boom, boom, boom. You see? But of course, anytime you do a knee, and you can create the body, or a kick, or any blood force, and carry that through with the body force, bringing it into the knee and driving the force into it, of course, is much better. Adds force to it, adds control to it. Because when we take that hit, boom, we take it, we've got control, and then we have opportunities that lead off of that. We don't stop unless they drop. We talk about a cascade of violence. A cascade of violence. One violent act takes another violent act, he gets a reflex as his turn, and we do our next chest move. Alright? Ready for it? I'll walk towards you. One and two, follow up. Techniques work the Fairbairn method. This is light-winded motion. Light-winded motion is heavily based in the works of William Ewart Fairbairn. It's a very dynamic methodology. Short system combatives. Get to the point, get the job done. Thank you very much, Eric. Thank you very much.